हॅलो डिअर स्टुडंट्स, माय सेल्फ संतोष नपते, वर्किंग ॲज अ असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मायक्रोबायोलॉजी, संभाजीराव केंद्रीय महाविद्यालय, जळकोट. वेलकम ऑन माय यूट्यूब चॅनल मायक्रोबायोलॉजी बाय संतोष नपते. सो फ्रेंड्स, आय एम गोइंग टू अपलोड व्हिडिओ लेक्चर्स ऑन लाईफ सायन्सेस. And these videos are useful for those students who are preparing for CSIR, NET, Life Sciences, or those who are preparing for GRF. And also these videos will be useful for those students preparing for state eligibility test, as well as those are preparing for MSc entrance exams. I have uploaded some videos on my YouTube channel. So, अगर आपने ये YouTube channel subscribe नहीं किया हो तो इसे subscribe कीजिए, ताकि जो भी videos मैं upload करूंगा उसके बारे में आपको notifications मिल जाएंगे. Because after uploading videos on my YouTube channel, it is not possible to send link to every students. So that's why kindly subscribe this Microbiology by Santosh Napte, so you will get notifications about new videos. So today I am going to start a first lecture on this CSIR NET Life Sciences online lecture series, and today's lecture is about signal transduction. So let's start signal transduction. So friends, welcome again in free online lecture series for CSIR, NET, JRF, SLET aspirants. And for these video lectures, subscribe this Microbiology by Santosh Napte YouTube channel. If you like my teaching, then click on like button, share these videos, and keep in touch for the next or upcoming videos. So today we are going to start our first lecture of this series, and this lecture is on signal transduction or cell signaling. So in this topic today we are going to see about the points which are to be covered includes introduction to signal transduction. Then we will see what kind of signals do cells receive. Then how do cells identify signals. Then we will see what are receptors. And finally, in this lecture, we are going to study about how do cells respond to signals. तो ये पांच टॉपिक हम आज के लेक्चर्स में कवर करने वाले हैं. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ इंट्रोडक्शन टू सिग्नल ट्रांसडक्शन. सो ऑल लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स और ऑल सेल्स, दे हैव द एबिलिटी टू रिसीव एंड रिस्पॉन्ड टू द सिग्नल्स विच आर कमिंग फ्रॉम द एनवायरमेंट or which occurs beyond the plasma membrane of the cell. And this ability of these cells to receive and respond to signals from all environment, it is very important to the life of living organisms. If we take simplest organisms, that is bacteria for example, so these bacteria, they have the sense and they swims towards the high concentrations of nutrients such as glucose or amino acids. And for this response, these bacteria, they receive the continuous input from the membrane proteins which act as a information receptors. So whatever that signal is coming here, that signal, it is first recepted by the receptors presents on the plasma membrane of these bacterial cells. So these signals, which are received by receptors present on the plasma membrane, they induces proper response to these signals. That may be, for example, in this case, or in case of these nutrients, there is a movement of these bacteria towards the food, that is towards the nutrients. And if there is a toxic substances are present, so that type of signal is also received by the bacteria, and they move away from that toxic substances. Or if there is a depletion of nutrients in the medium, so in such cases, that bacteria, they form the dormant spores to survive in that environment. Then, so unicellular organisms, for example, unicellular eukaryotes, they have also has the ability to respond to signaling molecules. And these signaling molecules that may be secreted by the other cells, and they allow cell-to-cell communication. So that eukaryotic cells, like that of prokaryotic cells or that bacteria, they also respond to the signaling molecules which are secreted by the other cells. And so that cell, they get response to the signaling molecules, and there is a cell-to-cell communication takes place. Another one example is here, that is mating between yeast cells. So this mating between yeast cells, it is signaled by a peptide which is secreted by the one yeast cell, and it get bind to the receptor present on the surface of another yeast cell. So once that peptide get bind to the receptor present on the another yeast cells, so there is a mating will takes place. In next slide, I will show that diagram here. Then later on, in multicellular plants as well as in animals, that cell signaling, it is also occurs by different types of signaling molecules. And these signaling molecules, these are secreted or expressed on the surface of one cell, and they get bind to the receptors present on the another cell. So these plant cells, they respond to the growth hormones, and they get also response to the variations in the sunlight. Then see this exchange of information about concentrations of glucose and ions in extracellular fluids takes place in animals. This is also the one another example of signal transduction here, in which there is a exchange of information takes place, and that exchange of information, it is about the concentration of glucose or ions which are present in the extracellular fluids in animals. And the correct placement of the cell in embryo during the embryonic development. So that is also the example here. If there is a signal will be transducted here, and finally that signal or that response, it is in the form of correct placement of cells during the development. See, this is the example of that yeast cells where there is a mating takes place here. See, this is the first step here, in which there is an exchange of mating factors. So each yeast cell, it secretes a mating factor, and that get bind to the receptors present on the other cell here. See, this is the yeast cell mating type A, and this is the another yeast cell which is called as mating type alpha, for example here. So these are the receptors present on the yeast cell, and this is the alpha factor which is secreted by the another yeast cells here. So this act as a signaling molecule here, and this signaling molecule, it get bind to the receptors present on this yeast cell, mating type A. So in second step here, there is an actual mating takes place, and this binding of the factors, which is called as the alpha factor, for example here, this binding of alpha factors to the receptors induces changes in the cells. See, there is a changes in the cell shape takes place here, and that lead to the fusion of these two yeast cells. And there is a formation of new cells that is known as A alpha cell here. So the nucleus of this fused cell, it includes all the genes which are coming from the both type of yeast cells, that is yeast cell mating type A and yeast cell mating type alpha. So this is the example of signal transduction here, in which that two yeast cells, they और बिटवीन देयर देयर इज अ मैटिंग टेक्स प्लेस. सो व्हाट एवर दैट एग्जांपल्स वी हैव सीन हियर, इन ऑल अबव एग्जांपल्स दैट सिग्नल मीन्स हियर इंफॉर्मेशन विच इज डिटेक्टेड बाय अ स्पेसिफिक रिसेप्टर प्रेजेंट ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ दैट सेल्स एंड दैट इंफॉर्मेशन later on it get converted to a cellular response which is always a chemical process. Whatever that cellular response is given by that particular cell, it is generally or it is always in a chemical process or in a chemical form. And this conversion, so whatever that conversion of that information into a chemical change, that is simply called as signal transduction. Means when that signaling molecules are released by one cell, for example here, that signaling molecules get bind to the receptors present on the another cell, and that another cell gives response to the signals released by that particular cell or that from that surrounding environment. So this mechanism, this process, it is simply called as signal transduction process. So whatever we have learned up to this year, now we must know these words here, for example signals or signaling molecules or ligands, then receptors, then signal transduction process here, or cell signaling and response. See, this is the general mechanism here, how that signal transduction process takes place. Simple mechanism, later on we will see in detail, but in this is the introductory lecture about this signal transduction. So just you know briefly what is meant by signal transduction. See, this is the cell wall of this bacteria or any cell wall here, and this is the extracellular environment, for example, and this is the intracellular environment here, or which is called as cytoplasm. So here the first step in signal transduction, it is nothing but the reception in which that particular signaling molecules, that may be hormone or any other chemical component, or it is a stimulus from the environment. So that signaling molecules get bind to the receptors present on the that cell surface or in the plasma membrane here. So here this is the plasma membrane. Then later on, in second step of signal transduction, which is actual a signal transduction here, which causes occurrence of many reactions producing secondary messengers or second messengers here. And these second messengers actually causes the transcription or translation and transcription, and finally it results into the response by that particular cell, and that is nothing but the activation of cellular response. This is the general mechanism of signal transduction. Then what kind of signals do cells receive? Cells mein konse prakar ke signals receive hote hain by that particular cells. So signals, actually these are chemical in nature, or these are chemicals. In case of prokaryotic cells, there are sensors are there, and that sensors, they detect the nutrients presenting surrounding environment, and after detecting that nutrients or detecting that signaling molecules here, that helps to the prokaryotic cells or that bacteria to move towards their particular nutrients. Then in case of multicellular organisms, there are growth factors are there, hormones are there, neurotransmitters are there, and extracellular matrix components are there to which that particular cells gives the response, that is nothing but the signal transduction. So these are nothing but the kind of signals which are received by the particular cells. In case of bacteria, that signals are nothing but the nutrients which are sensed by the sensors. In case of multicellular organisms, these growth factors, hormones, neurotransmitters or extracellular matrix components, these are nothing but the signals. So these signals or signaling molecules, they exert their effects locally, that is at the site of that presence, or sometimes they travel over long distances, and after reaching to that particular location, they exert their effects at that particular location. Neurotransmitters, which are the short range signaling molecules, they travels across the tiny or very small spaces which are present between the adjacent neurons or between the two neurons and the or present between the neurons and muscle cells. So these are the whatever the transmission of that neurotransmitter takes place here, that is close to the cells, for example here neurons. And another one example is here, that is follicle stimulating hormone, which travels from the mammalian brain because it is secreted by the pituitary gland here and or released by the pituitary gland, and it reaches to the ovary in the female where it triggers the release of egg, or that is called as the ovulation process. So in this case, that follicle stimulating hormone, it is moving much long distance to reach the target. See, this is the example here how bacteria monitors nutrient concentration, and this type of signal transduction, it can be explained by the two component signal transduction system in bacteria, which is a very important system, which is called as two component signal transduction system. So that we will see here how that two component signal transduction system works in bacteria. This is two component signal transduction which takes place in bacteria, and here we are studying how these bacterial cells, they monitors nutrient concentration. So this is the environmental signal here, and this transmembrane protein, which is a receptor present on the cell membrane of that bacterial cell, it is called as sensor kinase. So this membrane protein, it is called as sensor kinase, which sense an environmental signal, or it gives, or it is sensory to the environmental signal. This sensor kinase, it autophosphorylates on specific histidine residue present in that protein molecule, and this sensor kinase, it transfers that phosphate groups to the another protein, so this get converted to ADP, that is adenosine triphosphate, and this another protein, it is present in the cytoplasm, which is called as response regulator. So this is the response regulator protein here, and this protein, it activates the response regulator so that it can induces or it can repress the transcription and translation of these genes. So if there is an induction of that transcription and translation process, it results into the appropriate response that by that particular cell, otherwise there is no response will be there, that is in case of this repression. So in this way, this two component signal transduction system, it works in bacteria. So that consists of here that environmental signal, then later on here this is a sensor kinase, and this is the, that is called as response regulator, and finally it gives the response to the environmental signals by that particular cell. See, this is the another example which we have seen in previous slides, that is neurotransmitters. So these are the two neurons, this is one neuron and this is the another neuron here. So this is called as synapse. So here there is a synapse is formed here. So these are the plasma membranes of this neuron here, and this is the plasma membrane of this another neuron. So here this is called as presynaptic neuron, and this is called as postsynaptic neuron here, and this is that presynaptic neuron which is at rest, and here this second diagram, it is the active presynaptic neuron. So here in this case, this is called as the voltage gated calcium 2 plus ion channels, and this is known as reuptake molecule here. This is called as synaptic cleft, and here so this is the enzyme, and this is called as the receptor which is present on the another neuron or nerve cell. So in this case, there is action potential is released, and it causes the release of this calcium 2 plus ion, that is the calcium 2 influx of this calcium 2 plus ions here, and later on which releases these neurotransmitter molecules. So there is a रिलीज ऑफ दीज न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर मॉलिक्यूल्स फ्रॉम दीज सिनेप्टिक वेसिकल्स. सो दीज न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर मॉलिक्यूल्स इट गेट बाइंड टू द रिसेप्टर्स प्रेजेंट ऑन दी अनदर नर्व सेल और अनदर न्यूरोन. सो दे गेट बाइंड टू दिस एंजाइम ऑल्सो हियर एंड इन दिस वे वंस दैट न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर मॉलिक्यूल्स गेट बाइंड सो इट गिव्स द रिस्पॉन्स by that particular cell. So in this way that neurotransmitter molecules or which are acting as the signaling molecules here and that induces response by the another nerve cell or by another neuron. So this is the another example how that signal transduction takes place here. I am explaining in brief here because in detail we are going later on. See, this is the another example here that is of the that follicle stimulating hormone which is released by the pituitary gland in the hypothalamus or in the brain here. And later on finally, so this is the complex mechanism here, but we have seen in previous slide that there are some signaling molecules are there which move far distances in the body. So that is the example here. And of it is of follicle release of that follicle stimulating hormone which later on releases the egg from the ovaries or which induces the ovulation process. So that is the example here. So that hormone or that follicle stimulating hormone, it is moving long distances. It is not acting locally. So it is moving long distances here. So next point we will see here, how do cells identify signals? अभी सेल्स में ऐसे कौन से मैकेनिज्म्स है या फिर कौन सी सिस्टम है विद द हेल्प ऑफ व्हिच दे कैन आइडेंटिफाई दैट पर्टिकुलर सिग्नल्स. सो दैट सेल्स दे हैव द प्रोटीन मॉलिक्यूल्स विच आर कॉल्ड एज रिसेप्टर्स एंड विच आर प्रेजेंट ऑन द सेल मेम्ब्रेन जनरल हियर दैट बाइंड टू द सिग्नलिंग मॉलिक्यूल एंड देन दे इनिशिएट द फिजियोलॉजिकल रिस्पॉन्स. सो हाउ डू दैट सेल्स आइडेंटिफाई सिग्नल्स? तो सेल्स में या फिर सेल्स के प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन पे कुछ ऐसे प्रोटीन्स है जिसे हम रिसेप्टर्स बोलते हैं. सो दैट रिसेप्टर्स दे गेट बाइंड टू दैट सिग्नलिंग मॉलिक्यूल्स एंड दे कॉजेस द रिस्पॉन्स और फिजियोलॉजिकल रिस्पॉन्स बाय दैट पर्टिकुलर सेल. सो देर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ रिसेप्टर मॉलिक्यूल्स आर प्रेजेंट एंड दीज आर फॉर डिफरेंट सिग्नलिंग मॉलिक्यूल्स. ऑल दीज रिसेप्टर्स मॉलिक्यूल्स दीज आर स्पेसिफिक फॉर स्पेसिफिक टाइप ऑफ सिग्नलिंग मॉलिक्यूल्स. For example, here these dopamine receptors, they are specific to dopamine only, or they can bind to dopamine. Insulin receptors, they are specific for insulin, or they can bind to insulin. Then nerve growth factor receptors, they can bind to nerve growth factor only, or which is also called as NGF. Then these receptors, they can respond directly to the light or pressure, and which makes that cell sensitive to the events which takes place in the atmosphere. Not necessary there is a only that particular signaling molecule should be present here, but that receptor, they can respond to the pressure or they can respond to the light or temperature also. See, next point is here, what are these receptor molecules? Abhi hame ye malum hua hai ki that receptors, they are present on the cell or inside the cell or and they give response to the signaling molecules or they can bind to the signaling molecules. But now we must know what are these receptors. Abhi receptors kya hai? So these receptors are transmembrane proteins which get bind to the signaling molecules which are present outside the cell and subsequently they transmit that signal through a sequence of molecular processes or switches to internal signaling pathways. So these are the transmembrane proteins and they get bind to the signaling molecules and later on they transmit that signal through a molecular processes or switches to the internal signaling pathways. There are four types of membrane receptors are present and these are called as, one is G protein coupled receptors, another one is ion channel receptor, next one is enzyme linked receptors and another one is here nuclear receptors. Whatever the names of these receptors are here, these are given according to the mechanism by which that receptor molecule they transfer that external signals from outside to internal or from outside to inside. For example, here that G protein coupled receptors, they transform that external signal to internal via protein action. Second one is here ion channel receptors, they transform that signal, that is through ion channel opening. Then that enzyme linked receptors or nuclear receptors, they transform that signal through enzyme activation. So in this way, that receptors have the names according to their mechanism involved in the transformation of signals from outside to inside. So because of membrane receptors, they interact with both extracellular signals and they interact with the molecules present within the cell. So they permit signaling molecules to cause a cellular function without entry of that molecule inside the cell. So there is no need of entry of that signaling molecule inside the cell, because that membrane receptors, they interact in extracellular environment as well as in intracellular environment. So that's why they permit the signaling molecules to cause that response of the cell without entry inside the cell or in the cytoplasm. And not all receptors, they exist on the exterior of the cell. There are some receptors are also there which exist deep inside the cells or sometimes even in the nucleus. And these receptors, they get bind to the molecules that can pass through the plasma membrane. For example, here gases like nitrous oxide and that steroid hormones such as estrogen. See, this is the another example here, which is type of, which explains the type of receptors here, and this is the example of ion channel activation. So here, see, this is the acetylcholine receptor, which is shown in green color here, and it forms a gated ion channel here. See, this is the gated ion channel in this plasma membrane, and this receptor, it is a membrane protein. This receptor, it is a membrane protein which has the aqueous pores here. And this receptor, it allows the entry of soluble materials, or it allows soluble materials to travel across this plasma membrane when this ion gate opens or when this receptor gate opens. And when there is no external signal is present, that is in the absence of external signal, the pores are closed. This pore is closed here. See, this later on here, see, this is the difference here. This is the opening of pores here, but here the pore is closed. And when that pore is closed, when there is the absence of external signal. So this pore is closed here, and when that signaling molecules are present here, for example, acetylcholine molecules, which are shown in blue colored here. So these signaling molecules, so they get bind to the receptors. See here, there is a binding of these acetylcholine molecules to these receptors here. So they get bind to the receptor, and this binding of acetylcholine to these receptors, it triggers a conformational change in this receptor molecule. So there is a conformational change in this receptor molecule takes place after binding of that acetylcholine molecules here, which act as a signaling molecules. And this conformational change, it opens this aqueous pore. So there is a, after binding of these acetylcholine receptors, this aqueous pore, it get opens and it allows the entry of ions, which shown in red color. So after opening of this aqueous pore, these ions get enter inside the cell. So there is a activation of this receptor takes place here, and finally later on that signal transduction mechanism will take place, and finally that causes or that gives the response. So how do cells respond to the signals? Now the next point we will see here, how these cells, they respond to signals. So once that receptor proteins, it receives a signal, then it undergoes a conformational change, as we have seen in that previous slide. It undergoes conformational change and it launches a series of biochemical reactions, or which is also called as cascade. So these intracellular signaling pathways or signaling transduction cascades, they amplify the message and it produces multiple or many intracellular signals. Then activation of that receptors, it can trigger the synthesis of small molecules which are called as second messengers. And these second messengers, it initiate and coordinate intracellular signaling pathways, that is inside the cell. For example, here the cyclic AMP or is a common second messenger which is involved in the signal transduction cascades, and it is also a first second messenger discovered. So the cyclic AMP, it is synthesized from ATP or adenosine triphosphate by the enzyme known as adenylyl cyclase, which is present in the cell membrane. Then this activation of this adenylyl cyclase, it can result in the formation of many cyclic AMP molecules. So once this adenylyl cyclase get activated, and then later on there is a formation of many cyclic AMP molecules. And these cyclic AMP molecules, later on they activate the enzyme protein kinase, which then phosphorylates many protein substrates by attaching the phosphate groups to that particular protein. And later on, each step in that cascade, it further amplifies or multiplies in the initial signal, and then phosphorylation reactions mediate the responses in that particular cell or by that particular cell. This is the one. See, this is the another example of second messengers, which includes diacylglycerol or DAG and inositol 1,4-5-triphosphate IP3. So both of these second messengers, these are produced by the enzyme phospholipase, which is also a membrane protein. So this IP3 causes the release of calcium 2+, another second messenger from intracellular stores, and together this DAG and calcium 2+, they activate another enzyme called as protein kinase C, or which is also called as PKC. See here one example, that is signal transduction cascade involving a cyclic AMP. So this binding, this is the example which is related to the hormone adrenaline, or which is called as epinephrine. So this binding of adrenaline to the specific receptors, which are called as adrenergic receptors, it causes the initiation of cascade of reaction inside the cell, and the signal transduction cascade begins or starts when that adenylyl cyclase, which is a membrane bound enzyme, is activated by G protein molecules associated with that adrenergic receptor. And this adenylyl cyclase creates a multiple cyclic AMP molecules which activate protein kinases, that is PKA here, and these protein kinases can enter the nucleus and causes the transcription, or which affect the transcription process. See, this is the diagram of that example here. See, this is the epinephrine or adrenaline. It get bind to a specific receptor present on the plasma membrane, which is called as beta adrenergic receptor. So this beta adrenergic receptor, it is associated with this G protein. So this complex here, that is hormone receptor complex, it causes the guanosine diphosphate bound to GS alpha to be replaced by the guanosine triphosphate, which activate this GS alpha. So here that GTP get bind to this GS alpha and it get activated. So this activation of this GS alpha separates from the GS beta gamma. So this gets it gets separated from this complex here. See, this is the separating GS alpha unit, and it moves to adenylyl cyclase, and there is activation of this adenylyl cyclase takes place. So this adenylyl cyclase later on, it catalyzes the formation of cyclic AMP. So this ATP, now it results into the cyclic AMP, and this cyclic AMP, it get activates protein kinase A. So it activates that protein kinase A, and later on phosphorylation of these cellular proteins by this protein kinase A, it causes the response or cellular response to this epinephrine molecule. And here that cyclic AMP, So this cyclic AMP get degraded, which causes the reversing of the activation of phospho, that is protein kinase A, and it results into the formation of this 5' AMP. And this reversing process, it is catalyzed by the enzyme known as cyclic nucleotide phosphodiesterase. So friends, here we have completed this first lecture, and in next lecture we will see about the general properties of signal transduction. Then we will see signaling molecules and their receptors, and then we will see modes of cell to cell signaling. So hope आपको ये लेक्चर, फर्स्ट लेक्चर आपको पसंद आया होगा. सो इन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी विल ट्राई टू कम लाइव ऑन यूट्यूब और अदर प्लेटफॉर्म. सो थैंक यू. वॉच दिस वीडियो कंप्लीटली. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स, कमेंट ऑन कमेंट बॉक्स और यू कैन आस्क. थैंक यू वेरी मच.